I explain about the research philosophies and I talk about the three major research philosophies, which are positivism, constructivism and pragmatism. Okay, if you have not clear about these things, you can check out my previous lecture, or if you are clear, then we can move on. So this is the first decision any researcher have to make while they are doing their research. So this is about whether your research is based on positivism, constructivism or pragmatism. Okay, so let's move on with this. This is our first layer of research onion, where we decide about our research philosophy. So you can choose among these three, and there are many other research philosophies available, but mainly they are attributed to these three major research philosophies. So that is why there is this is the main three approaches of research. So you can use these research philosophies in your research. So I think you have already decided whether your research is positivism, constructivism or pragmatism in approach or in philosophy. Let's move to the next point, where we have two different approaches, research approaches. When we use reasoning, scientific reasoning or philosophical reasoning, there are two major attributes or approaches we can use during our research process. These are called deductive or inductive reasoning. Mainly deductive reasoning is more towards your quantitative analysis, where we have a theory, established theory, from where we decide our hypothesis, and then we collect data or do observation, and then we confirm our hypothesis based on the data. So the research or the reasoning would be started from theory. So first we develop theory, then we hypothesize, and then we collect data and confirm our result is based on the data, whether they confirm the theory or not. So this is called deductive in nature, while this reasoning mainly start with the theory. So if you already have established theory, for example, in my case, I already explained, I'm talking about digital marketing and sales. So it is already established relationship. What I'm trying to do is trying to reconfirm or confirm whether this practical relationship really exists in the reality or not. For this reason, I will explain my result based on the data. So it is started with theory, then we develop hypothesis, then we collect data based on the observation or any other form of data. So observation is related to your data collection, and finally we do confirm our hypothesis based on the analysis. The second approach is inductive. Inductive is mainly qualitative approach, or maybe we can consider it, this approach start with the observations. When first you observe any specific problem, issue or any specific reason. So you start your reasoning with the observation, and then you decide some pattern, or you try to collect some data using some interviews or some other mechanism. So this is how you try to draw some patterns of your observation of any problem, and then you will hypothesize, and finally you will present a theory. Okay, so it is inverse in process or reverse in process with deduction. In deduction we start with theory, in induction we start with observation, maybe starting with some interview, some discussion, panel discussion, or maybe discussing with your fellows, fathers or any other people, colleagues, where we discuss about some problem and we try to develop some pattern from out of that discussion, and then we hypothesize, and then we develop theory. So this is difference between deductive and inductive studies. Now you have to decide whether your research is inductive in nature or deductive in nature, whether you are going to start with the interviews and then you will develop a theory at the end of your research, or you are going to confirm the relationship which already exists between the variables or between your constructs. So that is called deductive. Now these two approaches are widely used, and that form second layer of your research onion, where you have to decide whether your research is deductive or inductive in nature. So first layer is your research philosophy, second layer is your research approaches. Now let's move to next step. strategies. So first we decided about our research philosophy. The second we started about discuss about the research strategies or approaches, and then we have research approaches, and now we have research strategies. There are different research strategies are available. Why and how you are going to conduct your research is basically your research strategy, and it is very important decision. You can do an experimental research like lab research or any other experimental research. In experimental research, we do research based on some already established principles, or in lab setting, or already define some parameters of your constructs, and we try to do some experimentation and try to evaluate the changes in one variable, how it affects other variable. Okay, so mainly it is under some lab setting or some controlled environment. The second type of the research is survey research, which we conduct through questionnaire, interview, or any type of survey where we directly meet with respondent, or indirectly through emails or any other forum. So we conduct those research based on surveys. So we collect survey, we collect data through survey, either it is a structured, semi-structured, or open questionnaire or interviews. In all these cases, we try to collect data directly from the respondent, and then we use it for our further analysis. So this is survey research. The next step is basically the case studies, where you are interested to solve any particular issue, the real-time issue maybe an industry, society, or humanity is facing. In that case, this would be a case study. Mainly in one organization, if you are facing some problem and you are trying to solve that problem, and you studied how the people or how the management they solve that particular issue, is called your case study. Okay, so mainly case study is dependent on one organization or one society or one community. Okay, now action research is another form of research where the researcher is involved in the process of observation. So it is not in case study, the researcher is not a part of the research, he is just an observer. He will just observe and report his finding. But in action research, the researchers are part of the research process, and they take participation in the they participate in the decision making process and all process through which this research has been conducted or the problem has been solved. So in action research, the researcher may be part of that organization, may be the part of that particular issue, and maybe it will need some time, maybe 6 or more months to do this research, because researcher would be act like as a participant, as a contributor, or as an influencer on the decisions process. So that is action research. And finally, the grounded theory. In terms of this next step, the grounded theory is another form of research, and it is basically a qualitative type of research, whether you want to find out or develop any theory. So grounded theory will start with the observation, the way I told you about the induction process. So inductive thinking, it is basically based on the grounded theory, where you start with some observation and end up with the theoretical development. You collect data through interviews or any other form and try to develop theories based on the both interviews or qualitative data. Okay, so that is grounded theory. Mainly it is a qualitative type of research. And then ethnography is another form of research where you want to study culture, norms, societies of any different country, region, or different people. So you have to spend some time, maybe 1 year or 2 years, with those different cultures, and try to articulate what are the differences and common practices between your culture and other culture. Or if you want to study a particular facet or particular concept, or maybe a particular function or a particular important aspect of their community, for example culture and their beliefs, norms, values, religion. So all these are basically ethnography. So you have to stay, the researcher have to stay with the existing culture for 1 or 2 years, and then he will observe and write his answer based on his observation. So that is ethnography. In the ethnography, mainly we study on the cultures and norms and societies. Okay. Now, archival research is a form of research where we use already published material. We use published or maybe already available archives in order to articulate any research or any form of the output to solve any problem. So in archival research, the researcher may use already published material, maybe research article, books or any other document, for example performance appraisals or all project reports. So all these documents are already published and available in organization or library. So you can use library, organization resources, online resources, all resources where you can find all these published material. They are called archival research. Okay, so these are some of the main strategies which you can use during your research. So you have to decide, or you have to define, whether your research is experimental based, you are using survey, or you are going to do case study, whether your research is action, because some of your some of my students, they have already done their six months internship. It means that you can use that experience for action research if you were involved in any decision making or any problem solving procedure. And then you can use grounded theory. Mainly those who are doing qualitative research, they would follow the grounded theory rule. So if you are using qualitative research, mainly you are doing grounded theory at the basic level. Okay, and then ethnography is related to culture. If you are using this type of approach, that is also possible. So you have to define whether you are doing ethnography, which culture, which society are you going to study. And then archival research is basically a form of research where we use existing documents. So if you are doing that, that is also possible, but you have to mention what strategy for your research you are going to adopt. Okay, now this is basically your third layer of research onion. So you can use this third layer and you can define your research strategies. The next layer would be more on what type of research methods you are going to use. You can use either one method, qualitative or quantitative. You can use mixed method, means that qualitative or quantitative, sequential or other parallel or sequential. But in some cases you use multi-method, means that it is not only qualitative or quantitative, you use simultaneously different process, qualitative, quantitative, then quantitative, qualitative. So means that it is not just two methods at the same time, but you are using different type of the research at the different stages of your research process. So that is called a multi-method research. So that is your fourth basic form of your research process. And then you can fourth layer of your research onion, you can use this to understand or to identify which type of research choice you have and which type of your research choice is, whether you are doing mono method, multi method or mixed method. Okay, now this is your fourth layer of research onion. Then the next layer is very important, where you decide what would be the time horizon, whether you are going to do with the longitudinal or cross-sectional. In the cross-sectional research, we collect data one time only. It means that we do interviews or we do collect questionnaire only once. Okay, for example, the way I'm doing my research in for example, the digital marketing and sales, it means that I'm just using a questionnaire and I will collect data once. Okay, but in some research, you cannot collect one-time research. Or maybe if you are using secondary sources, you are using more than 5 years or 10 years of data. In our type of research, in primary research, we have pre-testing and post-testing, means that before experiment or after experiment, with before 6 months or after 6 months. Or maybe if you are studying some topic which needs several times of investigation, for example a patient's treatment of a particular disease which may take longer time, and you have to collect data multiple time during that process, and that is called a longitudinal research. Okay, so in the longitudinal research, the data would be based on the more observation and multiple times of observation. For example, 1990, 1980, 1981, 1982, 1983, 1985. If we collect data in all these 5 years, this is called longitudinal research. Okay, but if in the cross sectional, the main parameter is we just collect data once only, and that is called cross sectional research. So you have to define whether your research scope is cross sectional or you are going to do a longitudinal study. Okay, so mainly in my case, I was choosing cross sectional research, and because I am just collecting data once only. Okay, now this is your choice. This is your fifth layer of the process, so you can check whether you are using cross sectional or longitudinal research. Okay, now the final part is the center of this onion, is basically collecting data and data analysis. Now this procedure is very important, and it is basically your research design which involve multiple processes. For example, you have to define whether you are going to collect data through questionnaire or you are going to do interview. If you are going to do interview, it means that your scale through which you are going to measure the data or to collect the data would be different. Interviews are different. If you are going to go do for questionnaire, the questionnaire is different. So first you have to decide about your scale. So scale development would be your first step in this process. And once you decided about your scale, the next step would be, what would be your sample? What would be your sampling strategy? Sample size, sample selection, number of observations. So all these are basically your sampling strategy. I will explain these concepts in each of these concepts in different videos. But here, to make it easy for understanding this research onion, you have to be clear about the concept. So first you have to define about the scale. The second thing is related to your sampling strategy, what sample and how many observations you will take. And then once you develop this, you have to test your scale, and pre-testing and pilot testing would be the next step. Once you are done with that, you will go with the final data collection, and finally you will do analysis. In the analysis, you can do either qualitative or quantitative analysis. The strategies for both of these type of research are different. So I will explain all these points in upcoming videos, but here our topic is just to understand this research onion. So that is why I would suggest you to be very precise on it, and later we will discuss about how we can develop scales, we can do sampling, or how we can pre-test or pilot test. Okay, but here you have to define whether you are going for qualitative data or questionnaire. If you are using questionnaire, it means that you are going for quantitative. If it is closed and questionnaire, then you have to define the sampling strategy, who would be your respondent and what are the main respondent points. Okay, now this is a main point for the data collection, and this is the final layer of your research onion. So with this, we understand that this figure represents our research onion. This is very important diagram, and it gives us all the details we need for our research design process. Okay, now let me give you example of my research. My topic for this particular subject is digital marketing and sales, the impact of digital marketing on sales. So it is a positivism approach, because I'm going to use the quantitative data or number. My procedure would be more on deductive. I will use survey method, and I'm going to use mono method because it is only one quantitative method. I'm not going to use qualitative and quantitative together. It is just quantitative. So if you are using both methods together, it would be mixed method. Okay, now my data collection is one time only, that is why it is cross-sectional. And finally, I will use quantitative data analysis and using questionnaire for my research process, and the sampling or my respondent would be the people who are buying online product, and maybe we can use this information to write about our research design process. Okay, I hope so. This video is very clear, and you are aware or you can understand about the research onion now. So you have to define, this is your class activity, you have to define all these for your research process. So for each layer, you have to make your decision whether your research is positivism, constructivism, and pragmatism. You are using deductive method or inductive method, survey, case study, research action, or you are using mono method or multi method or mixed method research, or you are using cross-sectional or longitudinal data collection, and finally what would be your research sampling and your research data analysis tools. So all these you have to define in the research design process. Okay, so thank you very much, but this is your class activity. You have to write about these steps very clearly in one paragraph or two paragraph for each, means each layer. So it comprises of maybe 4 or 5 paragraph where you will discuss about the detailed discussion about your research design. Okay, now this is your continuation assignment or class activity. But later, one more thing you have to understand on this: these steps need further details. For example, how we develop questionnaire, what would be our sampling strategy, what are our data analysis tools and techniques. All these steps I'm going to explain in the further research process, because this is very important area of our research. But before starting these points, you should understand your research design very clearly. So in order to understand your research process, you should be able to understand about the research onion process. Okay, now this research onion is a very simple tool to write about your research design or to understand about your research design. So please use this information in your chapter 3 of your final year project or research thesis or any research methodology chapter, so you can develop your research onion diagram very clearly or very easily the way I explain it to you. Okay, I hope so this video is very clear, and if you have any question you can ask me. But if you are clear, you have to mention your research design layer wise. For example, layer 1, positivism, which is your research philosophy, research design, research approach, research strategy. So each answer you have to write in the comment box. Okay, thank you very much, and I hope so this lecture is very clear, and if there is any question you can ask me or you can write down in the comment box. Thank you, and have a very nice day.